Right. Malawi has got a lot of opportunities, and many people, they always aspire to start a business, but they don't know where to start. But then we have a few companies in Malawi that are showing potential and doing well, one of them being the company owned by this gentleman. First of all, let me say hello, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. How are you, sir?
Oh, fine.
Thank you.
So I would like to know you, if you can tell us more about yourself.
All right. I'm Kelvin Mpande. I'm the founder and CEO of KM Financial Consultants. Yes.
Okay, first of all, I would like to know in your businesses, because many people, they think that when you start a business, everything just moves easily and flowing easily without any problem. I would like to know first, when did you start your business?
The business started in the year 2012.
2012.
So that's when we had the very first client.
Okay. And
Yes.
what is the business about?
Our business.
Yes.
Right. Our business, we start from registering the business to the registrar of business. From the registrar of business, we take the same business to Malawi Revenue Authority.
Okay.
Malawi Revenue Authority, we register, you get the TPIN, we clear you, you access tax clearance. Then the tax clearance, you qualify to go to PPDA until we give you all those documents so that you can be able to bid and for the bid, you can say.
All right. So this actually you are helping other businesses
Yes.
to start a business,
Yes.
but you're helping them with the registration process.
Yes, right.
Okay. Mainly, what is the size of the business that you're dealing with at the moment?
Our target is small and medium enterprises
Small and medium.
because the small and medium enterprise, you know, most of them, they're not able to employ a full-time accountant.
Yes.
So we always be there for them. We provide education, tax education, we say, or how they can handle their how can they come up, how can they write and keep their records.
Yes.
Because for you to prefer to see the performance of your business,
Yes.
you need to write all the record, the expenses, the income, so that you can see the performance of the business.
Yes.
So we teach them or we train them how can they do that.
Okay.
Or if they cannot, we also help by day-to-day records up until preparing the report so that they can see the performance of the business.
Okay.
Yes.
When I listen to you, I can see that these are actually serious business operations.
Yeah, for sure.
A small business like mine, where it's a welding company, there's somebody in town there on a street corner is making furniture. Can they also use your service?
Yes. We don't want to leave any business behind because of the fee.
Okay.
If you are small,
Yes.
your fee is going to also be small.
Okay.
Sometimes if you don't have the fee,
Yes.
but as long as you reach the agreement, you need to provide the service so that you can be able to assess your business.
Yes.
Yes.
So at the moment, if you can just think, how many companies are you dealing with at the moment?
So far, we are managing more than 70 companies.
More than 70 companies.
Yes.
And then in the near future, what do you foresee yourself? How many companies do you think you'll be growing up to servicing?
All right. In the near future, we want to see ourselves opening branches all regions in Malawi.
Yes.
We also want to help the government to fight against unemployment because as long as our clientele is growing,
Yes.
we also will be employing a lot. We also provide internships,
Okay.
those who are just coming from school.
Right.
Because for you to apply a job, they would say you need to have 2 years' experience.
Yes.
So you're just coming from school, where are you going to get the experience?
Yes.
So we provide that internship so that you can be competent.
Yes.
Yes, because we believe competent comprise of qualification and experience. So we provide that.
Okay.
Yes.
And sometimes when people see somebody doing business like the way you're doing, they always think you don't meet any challenges. Do you also face any challenges in your business?
The challenge is a bit funny.
Yeah.
The main challenge is many people, they don't know that we exist and we can help them with MRI issues.
Yes.
That's a very big, you meet a person registered with MRI maybe 4 or 5 years ago.
Yeah.
He has not done anything.
Yes.
It's a big challenge because the problem of the client becomes our problem.
Yes.
So now we know that without furnishing the accounts during the specified period,
Yes.
MRI will estimate, or when you submit,
Yeah.
you will be charged penalties.
Yeah.
So that problem becomes our problem.
Okay.
So we are here to tell people that even if you register with MRA,
Yes.
you don't do any business,
Yes.
you still need to file what we call new returns.
Yes.
Within the specified period.
Yes.
If you don't submit, you'll be charged late submissions.
Yes.
You see, so we are there to tell people, to give guidance, to advise them, and to do specifically about taxes.
Okay.
Yes.
I just heard you mentioning tax.
Yes.
A small business like mine, when they hear the word tax, we just want to jump through the window and run away. Do you think that the process, what is the benefit for a small business like mine or somebody on the street corner to go and register for tax?
One, you become a responsible citizen.
Okay.
Also, when you register with the MRA, MRA can only clear somebody who is registered who has the TP.
Yeah.
So there are some other businesses whereby you need to bid.
Yes.
For you to bid, you need to have a tax clearance.
Yes.
So you cannot have a tax clearance without registering with the MRA.
Yes.
So if you are small, you need to register, you give your TPN.
Yes.
So when you have a TPN, you can be able to apply for tax clearance. So they can be able to what?
Yes.
To be.
Okay.
Yes.
So it just shows me that it's very important for somebody to register for tax.
Yes.
What are the implications for a small business like mine if you don't have, if you don't apply for tax?
If you are not tax compliant?
Yes.
Sometimes there is what the MRA call inspection.
Yes, uh-huh.
They move around.
Yes.
When they find your business, they ask you questions.
Yes.
Do you do rent? Do you pay rentals here? If you say yes,
yes.
The rentals itself, when it's commercial place,
yes.
You need to pay withholding tax.
Yes.
Withhold from the amount you pay to the landlord, which is 20%, and submit to MRA.
Yes.
If you don't, it's a problem.
Yes.
Now you say, okay, well, your income. Maybe you started, when did you start the business? Maybe 5 years ago.
Yeah.
You're not registered.
Yeah.
They will get that 5 years and estimate to say, okay, you need to pay this amount of taxes because you didn't register.
Yeah.
So it's always be a problem. It always bring confusion because you have never expected somebody just coming in.
Yeah.
And by law, everyone should be tax compliant.
Yes.
You know, so it becomes a problem for small businesses. So I need to pay these taxes.
Yes.
So when you are registered, if you are registered, you're submitting your accounts. If the accounts you have done loss, you cannot pay tax.
Yes. So if somebody out there who's got a very small business and he is having doubts on whether he should go to MRA and register for tax because he's afraid, how can they come to you and then how can they find you, yeah, so that you can advise them?
All right, we are situated in Falls, house number 50. Our phone numbers, our phone number is 0999-013697.
Okay.
0999-013697.
Okay.
For you to just come in and consult about taxes,
yes.
We don't charge you anything.
It's free.
When you are here, you enjoy your free Wi-Fi.
Yes.
You get the consultation.
Yes.
When we always guide you what to do.
Yes.
This is what you're supposed to do. This is you need to take this step. Mm-hmm. If you don't understand anything, you need just a consultation, you can always call.
Okay.
As long as now you're stable to do business, then you can see how we can be charging each other.
Yeah.
So when you're just studying, we just give you guidance.
Yes.
And how you can go about.
So there you go. You've heard it yourself. If you are out there and you want to, your business to have have no issues with your tax and also even the business processes, you can come to his company and they will be able to assist you. Okay. Before we wrap up, what advices do you want? Would you give to somebody who wants to start a business like yours?
I want you to start a business like this.
Yeah.
One, it's not necessary that Kelvin is doing this business,
yeah.
Then anyone need to start business.
Yeah.
You know, some of us, we call this as a calling because
yeah.
Whatever you're doing, if you are doing, if you are making blocks,
yes.
If you are supplying computers,
yeah.
Well, what you have to do is you need to love what you do.
Okay.
When you love what you do,
yes.
It improves the quality of the service,
yes.
Of the output.
Yes.
You do it with passion.
Yes.
You love it.
Yeah.
The result will always be the best.
All right. So you heard it for yourself that if you want to start a business, you first need to find your passion. It's not because somebody else is doing something, then you have to copy. But find what your passion. And if you have a passion for what you're doing, you will always be successful. I am very happy that you gave me this time to speak to you. And again, I would like to know for you to give us the details again so that people who want to contact you, they can call you. Or they can come to you, or if you have an email address, then we can also send you an email.
The number, we are situated in Falls, house number 50.
Yeah.
The phone number is 0999-013697.
Yeah.
And the email address is kmfinancialconsultants@yahoo.com.
All right. Yes. What message do you have for our fellow Malawians as we finish up?
The message I have is let's all be tax compliant to support the government, because the source of government funds, specifically taxes, so we need to be tax compliant so that the government also can use the same money to developmental projects. In this business we are in, we are not only for profit making, we're also there for development, because we are bringing more people in the tax net so that they can be compliant. We are making people to understand what's still about taxes.
Yes.
Now, even if you go to MRI right now, they would say, if you want to have a TPIN, they would say, go and do it online.
Yes.
But you know that in Malawi, the internet usage is about 12.7%.
Yes.
So now we have access to generate TPINs for all our clients. Everyone who wants to register a business, you just come in to us.
Yes.
We just get the details from you, then we generate the TPIN for you.
Yes.
So let's all be tax compliant. We're there to make you understand about anything, any accounting related issues, taxes, bookkeeping, we are there for you.
Yeah.
For any consultation, just want to inquire anything about taxes, about accounts, you just need to call. We will not even charge you. We just want to give you a guidance on what to do. When you are stable doing business, you still need other stuff, then you call us, and if there will be a need of a fee, we're going to charge you. We, as I said, you're not in there for profit making. That's why we are there, even to create job opportunities for the young people. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kevin. If you want to know more about his company, you can always contact me at 0888-49815. 0888-49815. Or you can send me an email at tquerepeta@gmail.com. Thank you very much for watching the video. Thank you.